Hello and welcome to the all the viewers. Today we will talk about center of gravity as well as centroid in x, y and z direction in design modeler as well as ANSYS mechanical. So in this presentation we will try to see how to find out center of gravity or a CG in design modeler as well as ANSYS mechanical. So we will also try to see how to find out the mass as well as volume using ANSYS mechanical. Okay, then we will start now. So this slide represents the learnings in this video. First, we'll discuss about small introduction of what is center of gravity as well as centroid. Then we will discuss about what is the need of CG locations in finite element analysis. Then we will see about how to find out the centroid in ANSYS design modeler as well as in ANSYS mechanical. So there we will also discuss about volume and mass detail extraction. Then finally we will see the effect of change of material in the centroid. So we will try to change the material details and we will see if there are any changes in the centroid. So this slide represents the center of gravity and centroid. So what exactly CG is? The center of gravity is a point which locates the resultant weight of a system of particles. So particles with different weights can be replaced by a resultant force of a weight W, which is located at the CG of the gravity. So if you see, this is what one of the schematic of base frame, and here you will see the point mass of 350 kg of a centrifugal pump is applied, as well as you can see this is what the motor. So this is the base frame of centrifugal pump as well as motor. So CG, as we discuss about, is a point which locates the resultant weight of a system of a particle. So basically centrifugal force consists of number of components. So all these components having a weight of 350 kg is applied at the center of gravity location. So basically it is the point where the whole mass of the system is acting. The second term is centroid. The centroid is geometrical center of a plane figure or of an object. So it basically divides the shape into regions of an equal moments. Suppose if the density of a substance throughout the body is same, that is material is homogeneous, then the center of gravity is equivalent to the centroid. So basically centroid represent for a 2D plane figures, while CG is for a 3D components. So ANSYS design modeler as well as ANSYS mechanical gives the centroid in X, Y and Z direction. This is a CG location where assume or idealized mass will be applied. Okay, then we will see in our problem definition and ANSYS how to find out the CG for a respective components. Before that, we'll discuss the need of CG locations in finite element analysis. So basically, any mechanical system consists the number of components, and it is difficult to consider all these components in finite element analysis. And hence, there are few components which are unwanted for the simulations. So these components are idealized using mass elements. So also sometimes we need to analyze only few structural parts of the assembly, like we saw in a base frame. So basically when we talk about base frame of a compression and generator assembly, or we are analyzing only base frame, then what we will do, we will idealize the mass of the compressor as well as generator using mass element, and we will apply that at the CG location. Okay, so this mass element should be considered where the structure behaves as a complete model, and hence the center of gravity, centroid in X, Y and Z direction are used to apply the mass element. So if you see, this is what one of the schematic of top side model. So in this, if you see, there are few electronic components are attached at the middle of the assembly. So this electronic components are difficult to analyze, and also there is a no need to analyze. So in that case, we will do that by using the mass element. We will try to apply that at the center of gravity. You can see there are three point masses which are attached to this intermediate frame through this rigid element. So basically here what we did, we idealized the masses of the electronic components using mass element at the center of gravity. So what ultimately it does, it reduces the simulation time, as well as we will get the good amount of accuracy. So that's why there is a need of the CG location and finite element analysis. Okay, so what we will do, we will try to see how to find out these CG locations in ANSYS, in both like in design modeler as well as in ANSYS mechanical. Okay, then we will start now. So now we will see that how to find out centroid using ANSYS mechanical. So if you see, this is what one of the ANSYS module, and I had already modeled the pressure vessels over here. So there are, you can see like this is what your bottom head, this is top head, this is nozzle, and this is the shell part. So here it may consist of shell as well as solid pod assembly. So I will show you, hide all other bodies, these are the shells, and these are the solid bodies. Okay, so the purposefully I created that, show all bodies. Now if you go to tools, analysis tools, and here mass properties. So here if you click, you will find the details view like this. Here mass properties, and in this mass property you will able to find out the centroid X, centroid Y, and centroid Z. So basically it will represent the CG location for respect to all component. So I am selecting all and I am apply. So you can see the warning, like select the same types of entities for the mass property. The main, when we see the mass properties, there you should have the only solid as well as shell bodies. So suppose I am hiding these bodies and select all, tool, analysis tool, mass property, apply. So if you see here now, this is what the CG location at this point having X, Y, and Z directions, dimensions. So now suppose you want to see the mass properties only for a shell bodies, hide show body, hide all other body, select all and apply. So now you can see like for a shell body. So always keep in mind when you will try to find out the centroid, there should be separate solid as well as separate shell bodies as well as separate 1D bodies. It will not show for a combined different element types of what we can say, the different solid, shell as well as 1D bodies. It will not show the combined CG. It will always show for a respective entity types, like for a solid, for a shell, as well as for a 1D separately. Okay, this is what in a ANSYS design modeler. So what I will do, I will hide this now, shell bodies. I will select all the body, tool, analysis tool, mass properties, apply. Okay, now I will try to save this cell, and here I will try to write X, Y, Z. Okay, and from here I will copy X, Y, as well as Z. This is from design modeler. Now similarly we will try to find out from ANSYS mechanical. Okay, and then we will see if change in, we will see right now it is by default with structural steel, we will change with aluminium alloy. And this is R in mm. So now I will open my mechanical window, and here you can see the shell as well as solid body. So now you just first try to mesh with whatever the default size is there, clear generated data, and try to mesh that file. So in order to find out the centroid as well as mass details, I will hide this, and if you click here you can find, if you show, you will find some sort of duplicate elements. Select all, here you can go, and here on this details view you can see the masses of the whole bodies. So here it will depicts you the surface area as well as your centroid in X, Y and Z direction, and you can say it will further tell us like body, whether it is solid body or shell body, and it will show you the types also along with the radiuses and other geometric details. Now in mechanical it will show for the whole bodies, like for solid as well as shell body, but I want to see for a shell bodies or solid bodies only. So I will select all, and here you can see the centroid. I will further click, select all, click on mesh, and here you can find the selection information of, and from here you can find the solid as well as shell bodies. Actually it is showing for a face combination. Now there another way, you can select the geometry, go here, select all, and for that respective geometry it will only depicts the bodies. So either way you can find for surface as well as shell. And now this is what your centroid in X, centroid in Y and centroid in Z. And in our case we'll first change the material as per our mechanical design mode layer. I will select all and I will depicts on this. Now you can see the X, Y and Z. So it will show for all the bodies, and here if you go it can show as per local as well as global, and further here if you want only summary you can find from here. And now what I will do, I will copy this, Control C and Control V, copy, Control C, Control V. There is some problem with the copy. I will try to arrange side by side, and I will write manually 1.39 volume. So here 1.6968 e raised to minus 03, then minus 141.18, then 1.8545. Okay, so now here it is approximately 0, and here it is matching. So you can see from design modeler as well as from mechanical, your centroid in X, Y and Z axis is matching. Okay, now if you want for shell bodies separately, it will show for shell bodies what we saw in design modeler also. So you need to find out from this location. Okay, now what we will do, we will try to change the material details. So right now I will show you how to see this. If you click here, go to engineering data source, from here general materials, you will able to find out the materials from the library. I will use this aluminum alloy, and I will go to here. Now you can see the density difference is 2770 kg per meter cube, while structural steel, as we know, 7850. Now we will try to assign this material I will refresh this data. I will double click and I will select all. First this two. Here you can see aluminum alloy as well as all this true aluminum alloy. So by default I had already used aluminum alloy. Now I will just simply change that to structural steel first. Okay, and we'll just compare select all selection information, click on mesh or so you can see there is some problem with the Excel. Okay, so now you can see X, Y and Z. X, Y and Z both are matching. I will further change the material details. I will keep here aluminum alloy, here also aluminum alloy, right, and select all. So you can see with aluminum alloy also we are almost the same. I think I will copy as it is then here, right? So it means, as I think we know all these things, like center of gravity, which is like the dimensional property, or it is the when the material is homogeneous, so there will not be any changes in the centroid, okay, because it is not related with the material details. So that's why we didn't found any change with the aluminum alloy. So when you see in design modeler, when you see in mechanical, you are able to find out the centroid. So same centroid you can use for your respective analysis purpose. Okay, so thank you guys. Let me know your comments. I will be there to help you. Thank you once again.